just smoozing with Henry Winkler, and who wouldn't be? 45 things to ask you before we get to this great, great work on Barry opposite Bill Hader, which is just terrific.
Thank you so much.
Your son was here the other day, director
Max.
In his own right.
Yeah,
the nicest
Max.
Guy ever.
He told us when he was 10 years old, he said, I'm going to be a director.
Really?
And, of course, his mother said, well, you know what? You could be a lawyer first. And then you could ease
right.
into
right.
director. He
right.
said, no, he never wavered.
Right.
Really?
And is that, yeah. is that because I've had this conversation over the years with so many, gosh, it's worked out for Dad.
You know what? I don't think that was, it wasn't that I saw Dad.
Right.
And he just loved film, knew film. At 10, he could dissect movies on how they were made, what the problems were. And then his new movie is out now, Flower.
With great acclaim.
Just great. Just great.
All right. The generic question everybody's being asked, anyone who's ever had another television show.
Are you asking me this?
Yes.
Okay.
They're bringing everything else back.
Yeah.
Roseanne with 15 million viewers last
funny.
Night.
It was
very
just funny.
It is funny.
Yeah.
It was funny.
So when they say, let's open Arnold's again and do Happy Day.
I would buy a hamburger.
Okay. But would it appeal to
but
you?
But only
at it,
25
right,
cents.
Or does it seem silly to you?
No. I you know what? I don't know. It. I would never say I know what it takes to make entertainment. So if you get something that works,
yeah.
more power to
How
you.
How special was this time for you?
It introduced me to the world. They were unbelievable people to spend time with. Ron Howard is still my very good Aww. Friend. They taught me to play softball. I'm not a good sports person because I'm so dyslexic. I don't have good eye-hand coordination. Mm-hmm. They bought me a mitt. They bought me, and we traveled all over the country and the world
right.
playing softball. Aww. I was the pitcher.
Wow.
That's all I could do. I couldn't hit, I couldn't catch.
So what about reviving the softball team, if not the show?
Yeah.
That I could coach.
Okay, fair enough.
Yeah, these knees no longer could run first.
All right. Aww. Here's something you yes. said to me years ago, and I never forgot about it.
Oh my
because
God.
I was like, you've never stopped. And you said you've never stopped because some people, quote unquote peers, won't audition, and you're more than willing to
audition. I auditioned for Barry.
Barry's.
I went in and auditioned for Bill Hader mm. and Alec Berg. Mm-hmm. You know, and some actors say, you know, they know my work. They can see me on tape. But the fact of the matter is that a lot of the young people who are now at the networks or at the studios, they want to see that you are not using a walker.
Right. You know? And you play this acting coach, and it's such wonderful work. And I think a lot of us who are not thespians at all
right.
think there are all these cliches, and you're
right.
doing the work. And,
right.
and how much of it is BS?
Yeah, when it depends on the actor themselves.
Okay.
Some actors parrot what they hear other actors say
right.
when they're on a talk show. And some actors literally piecing together a character is so much fun. It is so, it keeps you on your toes. It's like putting together a jigsaw puzzle and all the pieces are blue. Mm. And you have to fit it, and then all of a sudden you've got a human being. At the end. Mm. It is just, I'm living my dream, actually.
All right, the conceit here is that Bill Hader's character also just happens to be this hitman, but Bill Hader's a good actor in real life, and
Bill Hader. He is co-producing with Alec Berg. He is co-writing with Alec Berg. They directed two episodes apiece, and he stars in it, and there is not a ripple of drama on the set.
Nice.
It is just easy peasy doing a wonderful show.
And this is it. It's HBO's Barry. Watch.
All right, here we go. We're walking down the aisle. Get your cart. Get your cart.
Pretend to do
All right, thing. you feel the handle?
Yeah.
Here we go. Now, take a look around. What do you see?
Soup.
We see soup. What kind of soup? Chicken noodle? Consommé.
I don't know.
What do you mean you don't know?
I don't know.
Just look at the shelf.
I can't.
Why?
Someone bought it?
No one bought it. That's a lie. Take your hands out of your pocket. Don't slouch. You're stuck. Barry, I need you to surrender. No. Stay in place. Don't move. Take your hands out of your pocket. Just surrender. Surrender to the soup, Barry.
Henry, that's awesome.
Did you ever have acting great coaches scene. Like that?
That scene came from a story I told them in my freshman year at the Yale Drama School. I had one of the grand dames of theater. And the exercise was, show me your garden. Create a garden. And I stood up, I opened the picket fence, and I said, and here are, sit down.
Oh.
I said, sit down. I didn't even show you my variegated tulips. You see nothing. Shut up. And I told him that story, and that's where it came from. And a third of that was improvised.
Right.
Take your hands out of your pocket, don't you, gum. There was an actor at the Repertory Theater when we were doing professional plays there at Yale who attacked me because I was chewing gum during a rehearsal.
Oh, my goodness.
But I mean, nearly threw me out of the theater.
But it made you better, right?
It made me better. Yes, I keep the gum behind my ear now.
Yeah. Henry on the road for promoting Barry. I think there's going to be more than this initial order. Sundays at 10:30 on HBO. And, of course, the children's book, 32nd kids book on the way. You, sir, are the
inspiration. We love you, Henry.
Thank you so much.
Such a pleasure
to be here.
Thanks so much. Thank you.
Thank you.